A few weeks ago, I was watching WandaVision, which is a fantastic show, by the way, and I saw this eye-catching color pop effect. And I thought to myself, I bet I could do this inside of DaVinci Resolve. So, in this video, I'm gonna teach you how to make this super easy color pop effect from WandaVision inside of DaVinci Resolve. And I'm gonna show you how to do it in only 3 steps. So all of that stuff and more coming up. If you're new here, my name is Billy Ripka and I make weekly videos all about teaching you to become a better video editor. So if you wanna level up your editing skills, click the subscribe button and the bell notification so you don't miss out on anything. So the first step in all of this is we have to make it monochrome. So inside of DaVinci Resolve, I have our clip right here, which is a helicopter. And since in WandaVision, it was a helicopter she was holding up, I thought that this would work pretty well. So all we're gonna do right now, once you have your footage imported, is go into the color page, and then I'm gonna go over to the RGB mixer right here. Then you'll see this checkbox with monochrome next to it. Just go ahead and check that. And our whole shot turns into black and white. Now the second step is to select that color that we want to pop out. So to do that, we're gonna have to add a layer mixer. So click on this node right here and hit Alt L on your keyboard. And then you can see it creates another node under it and combines it with this layer mixer. And this ultimately is gonna combine the layers together. So now to select the color I want, I'm gonna have to go down to the qualifier tab right here. And then I'm gonna go under selection range, and you have this turkey baster looking thing here. It's called the picker. So that's the worst name ever for a tool, but grab the picker and then select the color that you want. So I'm gonna grab this red color right here. And if I zoom in using the scroll wheel, I can get a better look at what I'm actually selecting. So once I've selected the color like this, I can actually move over to this picker add and add more to that selection range. Then I'll just go ahead and make sure that all of the red is selected. And if you wanna remove something, you can go to picker and subtract whatever color you want. Now, if I go to this highlight tool, this is gonna show all of the colors in our image that we have selected. And you can see clearly that it's not just selecting this red here, it's selecting the red in our scene. And the issue is that we don't want that. We want our helicopter to be the only thing in our scene with color. So this, my friend, is where refining comes in. So under hue, I'm gonna go to width and I'm gonna bring it up a bit just so that I make sure I'm selecting like all of the red that I want. Then I'll just move on to saturation and bring that up a bit like this. Now under luminance, which is our white and black values, I'm gonna go ahead and play with these because this is where a lot of our refining is gonna be. So I'll adjust the lows and the highs like this. Then I'll just bring up the L soft like this. And now I'm gonna go over here under matte finesse and under clean blacks, I'm gonna bring that up to around 9. So just be aware that when you're doing this clean blacks and clean whites, that if you bring it up a lot, yes, it gets rid of everything, but it's gonna add a really ridiculous over the top feather around everything and the color won't look super great. And yeah, so now to really make sure that we don't have these random red parts, I'm gonna turn off the highlight right here so you can see what we're working with. And then I'll go down to this window tab right here, then grab the pen tool and start creating a mask around this helicopter right here. And it doesn't have to be super tight to it. Ultimately, by us doing it, it's going to just eliminate all of these other random red specks around our shot. Also, if you mess up and you put a point somewhere that you don't want it, you can just hit the middle mouse button to delete it like that. So once you've finished your mask, you can go ahead and hit this highlight button again, and you'll see that it's only selecting the color inside of this mask right here. So now to make sure that this mask actually sticks with the helicopter, I gotta track it forward, right? I have to make sure that that mask stays to that helicopter because otherwise it's just gonna kind of like drift off and half of your helicopter will be black and white, half of it will be in color and it'll be kind of sad. So to track the mask, you gotta go to the tracker tab, duh. So right here, you can see this little tracker. It's kind of like a little crosshair type thing. So then I'm gonna go ahead and hit track forward, and DaVinci is just gonna track our mask to the helicopter throughout the whole clip. Now hit track reverse just to make sure that you got everything. Once we're done tracking, you can see that in a couple of areas, our mask actually goes over the helicopter, and like we said earlier, it's gonna make it black and white. So to fix this, I'm gonna go back to the tracker menu. Right now I have clip selected. So what that means is if I move this point, it's gonna move that point everywhere in the clip, and we don't want that. So I'm just gonna adjust the mask so that it doesn't go over our helicopter. Also, if you're getting value from this video, a like and even possibly a subscribe would be super appreciated. So now moving on to the third and final step for all of this is to add more colors if you want, right? If you're good and you're content and you just wanted that red to show up, that's fine. But there's some other colors in this helicopter right here that I want to show up. So what I have to do is add to this layer mixer by hitting Alt L on the keyboard. And you could go to the qualifier tab, select another color and do all of that. But I know that the color I want is inside of the helicopter. So what I'll do is go to the Windows tab right here, then grab the pen tool, and I'm gonna make a mask on the inside of the helicopter. Now you don't have to be super precise with it. You just have to make sure that you're staying within the helicopter and that the colors that you wanted, like if I wanted this blue right here, that it's actually being included inside of the mask. So once we have that, we're gonna go ahead and track this mask to the helicopter. So we have to go to the tracker tab, and I'm gonna hit track forwards and then track reverse. Now I'm gonna click on frame and make sure that my mask is staying to this helicopter, but not going down all the way into the city like this, because clearly it's gonna show a lot of color. We just wanna make sure that only inside of our helicopter is being selected. So I'll just move throughout the shot, making sure that it's good and tight to it. If you wanna go ahead and add more colors, you can just repeat that exact process. But I got a question for you. What other type of movie effects or TV show effects do you wanna see? Let me know in the comments below. Also, if you're looking to speed up your editing process and have high quality effects, check out our store. We recently have just released this awesome motion graphics transition pack. Anyway, if you want more videos, click on the top for a video with all of my DaVinci Resolve tutorials, or click on the bottom for a video that YouTube thinks that you would like. But until the next one, peace.